everybody is entitled to their own opinion. It's actually irrelevant for us to go back and forth with an individual after we've established our stance and what we believe towards God and about God. People want to go back and forth, that back and forth, so we go back and forth. But when we go back and forth, that back and forth only has to deal with establishing who's right or wrong. If we're going to deal with this prophetically and or spiritually, and if God is establishing a thing through someone we can say is a trusted prophetic conduit, then you don't really answer or have a rebuttal to an individual who simply chooses to ignore who it is God is speaking to or through and still establishing first and foremost what we say to a set of people who are fleshly driven. They're not even spiritually driven, they're fleshly driven. So the intentions of the audiences that some of us are reaching out to are never to join us in God's house before or after this COVID matter. So we build our platform to reach them that never intend to support the move of God in the first place. So our platform is now to reach out to a set of people who will join teams with. So if we're looking at joining teams, we're joining teams with. So if I'm going to join teams, I'm joining teams now, like the Pharisees and the scribes. I just need somebody to agree with my wrong. So if I find somebody to agree with my wrong, because our common good, what is the common denominator? Common good is the individual that I dislike for the moment. So I don't like the individual that God is speaking through. So if I don't like the individual that God is speaking through, I have to find a set of people who actually also disagree with, doesn't have to be the same thing I disagree with about that individual, but actually disagree with something about that individual so that we can actually find a way to discredit what that individual stands for or what he's speaking or what he has to bring forth or she has to bring forth. So the major thing is that we are not in this to go back and forth to try to prove who's right or wrong. God's people establish. We are establishers. So because we are establishers, then we establish a thing. Once we establish a thing, we don't have to prove a thing. God will prove the thing. We establish through faith. So we establish. So when we speak, we speak. We establish. So we establish today that the Lord has given us as his people a victory. We establish that. Now, many different people will choose to debate whether or not it's victory or not, because to them, basically, they say that how can you find victory in this when he's sending his people back to the lion's den? Not God, but then saying Trump is sending God's people to a trap. But then we serve a God who sends warning before destruction. So that same God that sends warning before destruction has already pre-warned us that we shall not go back in at this time. But at the same time, then he establishes the night before what the devil thought for your bad, I'm going to turn for your good. So then we get the recognition to the place of now the country, the leader of the country saying, we need more prayer, not less prayer. So we need this. We need the conjunction of the churches flowing. But we're asking at the same time that the leaders can actually operate in discipline and not greed, and to be able to operate not just at a level of discipline, but spiritual wisdom, so that we can gather the people together for the right cause. The right cause, the proper cause should be prayer, not to establish. We know the houses of God need money. We know the houses of God need to stay established to grow. Now again, watch this. We are not going back and forth. We do not have to dialogue back and forth with people who are going to call us a crook. Rather, they see our financial records or not. We are always going to be who Pharisees and scribes say we are, simply because they don't like us. Listen, the attack against God's people doesn't have to be truth. The attack against God's people just has to happen. So we have to learn how to stop rebuttaling, how to stop firing back once we've established. Because once we've established a thing, that's a wrap. God then comes back and proves. Jesus established to the tree. He looked at that tree. He says, "You are cursed." He walked away. He established that that tree was not fruitful. So we can't waste our wine and our goods. We can't waste what God has given us trying to come back and go back and forth. Establish the thing out of your mouth. Once you establish it, move on. You don't have to stand there and then dialogue the Bible and the Word of God back and forth again with people who know the Word of God or may not know the Word of God, and they're not looking for a spiritual or common resolution. They just dislike your stance and who you stand for and what you stand for. So I'm going to find something that I always disagree with that you're doing in order for me to be able to actually hinder or stop the progress of what it is you're doing. So we got to learn, just we have to learn as the body of Christ in this season that we are in, that we respond only when God pushes our button. When God says, okay, I now need you to speak. I now need you to say what needs to be said. That's then when we allow ourselves to be pulled out and to be used by God and not to be abused by man. Once we establish this, then we are actually in the proper will of God, because we can find ourselves working in full assignment, but then we'll pay attention to the threats of Jezebel in the midst of her or him actually challenging our stance and what we've established. And now the threats that will actually begin to come forth, meaning whatever it is, rather they join together and they try to discredit your character or your integrity, then this will actually cause God's people to give up. So we don't give up. We stay persistent, but we only speak when spoken to, not spoken to as of from Pharisees and or scribes, people challenging what we feel. Because the thing that you have to learn and that I learned myself is that the Pharisees and the scribes, they already knew the power of God. They were watching the power of God manifest itself. The problem that the Pharisees and the scribes had was they didn't have the attention that Jesus had. And that's what you have to just realize that this season, that some people dislike the attention that God is affording you to have this season. Rather it be the favorable attention, meaning I am favored. So because I am favored, there is like a release that's upon me where I'm attracting the blessings of the Lord, or I'm attracting the favor of God in these sessions, in these moments. This is great. So the enemy is going to have to hate the fact that you're actually attracting things that they cannot attract. But more than anything, like, we just, you know, we don't have to respond once we've established. And that's something that God has put in me as a prophetic message for the body of Christ. Not if we emerge from this, we emerge with more wisdom. We got to show our wisdom and let the world operate in its ignorance. The world will not understand our faith. They never have understood our faith, and they don't intend to understand our faith. So we only reach out to them that actually will give our faith an opportunity, instead of look for an opportunity to be able to tear down our faith. Our faith is actually stronger than ever. It's concrete for those that know who God is and what he's capable of doing. And we've been through something and watched God bring us out. This isn't even just a fact of just reading the Bible, but this is just like consistent testimony of the body of Christ. So I say to anybody in this season, once God has pushed your button and God says you must come forth, and you know it's God, and you got to establish something that comes from God. Establish the Word of God. And once the Word of God has been established, then you don't go back and forth and dialogue and or debate with an individual who has the anointing of Sanballat or any other person that's in the Bible that's only there never to support what you are doing, but always to challenge. So that's your hindrance, and that identifies now the spirit that you're operating against. And now you got one up on the devil, because now you know who the devil is using, how the devil is using them, and now you get to further the kingdom's agenda even greater, because now you know what type of spirit to bind. That was just something that I wanted to record prophetically, prophetic dialogue. So I pray that God's people be blessed, and you know, just trust in the Lord and know that God got us. And if we want to call this the COVID Chronicles, soon we will emerge. God bless you.